Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he was receiving the first ever wahi, he was there in Hira. So the first ever ayah, Hafiz Numan, what is this? Iqra. Bismi Rabbik. Yes, insist upon the word Rabbik. Why Allah did not say Iqra bismillah? Why Allah did not say Iqra bi ismil ilah? Why Allah did not say Iqra bi ismil rahman aw bi ismil rahim? While this Rabb is not included in 100 famous names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because this Rabb includes every quality and every attribute of Allah. That's number one. And number two, date first ever. Yes, because when something is there in your nature and you hear, oh, this sound is look like Mr. So and so. Because there is the print. The Rabb print is there in your ruh. So that's why the first ever wahi came, Iqra bismi Rabbik. To remind you that you admitted. To remind you that you have countersigned. My dear respected brothers and brothers in Islam. Then in Holy Quran, just say, we start Holy Quran from Surah Al-Fatiha. Alhamdulillah. Loudly. Rabb. Once again, Rabb. Then again and again, tens and twenties of times, we say, Rabb, Rabb, Ya ayyuhan nas, ubudu, Rabbakum alladhi. Ya ayyuhan nas, ittaqu, Rabbakum. When we go to the end of Quran, so the last two surah, we start with, Qul a'uzu bi Rabbil falaqi. Qul a'uzu. What is this? This is not a coincidence. There is a hikmah. There is a wisdom therein to recall you that deen bas yak. Yak nukta bashad episar, that deen hori soli is only one single point if you will understand rububiyyah. Yeah, the rububiyyah of Allah, and that's why Yahya ibn Mu'az al-Razi, rahmatullahi alayhi, great muhaddis and a great tabi'i, he says, man arafa nafsa faqad arafa rabbah. If you will recognize yourself that you are slave, then you will know Allah that he is your master. As long as you have not known yourself that you are a slave, how you will recognize Allah that he is your Rabb? Because you yourself is thinking that you are a great master and you are a great Lord. How you will believe in the lordship of somebody else?